Hello and welcome to Monmouth in Focus, a program about the services and functions of Monmouth County government. I'm Cynthia Scott, your host for this segment of Monmouth in Focus. And today we are joined by Freeholder Gary Rich, who serves as a liaison to the county administrator. Freeholder, thanks much for joining us.
Thank you, Cynthia.
Freeholder, you have been working very, very closely with the county administrator's office on a big plan and a goal. Tell us about that.
Well, when I first joined the board 2 years ago, one of the first things that I saw was that the county had been very, they had a lot of foresight and went out and put a strategic plan together. That was done in 2009. Coming from the business side, one of the things that we find that we really need is we need a blueprint for us as we move forward. Okay. County's very large. We have over 3,000 employees, an almost $500 million budget. And one of the best ways for us to move forward is to plan. So there were two initiatives in the plan that stuck out immediately and something that I thought we could really get done very expeditiously. We didn't have to wait a long time. We didn't have to collect a lot of data. One of them was the communications plan, and another one was the energy plan, with an eye on how we would could also solidify some of our buildings from a, I guess you could call it a crisis, perhaps a crisis intervention by looking at those energy functions. The first part that we worked on was the communication plan. Worked with our team, the public information officer, to take a look at how we were communicating. The first thing that we did was we brought in all of the different departments, because over time, departments were doing were great communication, but we weren't doing it in a way where the events, we could cross-market the events or talk about these events as a whole.
Yeah.
So that was really important. The second thing we did was we went out to upgrade our website. So we're doing a lot of social media. And then the third part of communications, again, trying to become more efficient, was taking a look at all of the outbound advertising, perhaps, that we were doing, so that we might want to bring that back into house, in-house. And so the team has worked really, really very well. We've made some great strides. If you go to our website today, you can see it's a wonderful website, plenty of information, clearly defined. Along the right-hand side, you'll see boxes that talk about Sandy, that talk about our initiative around Grow Monmouth that Freeholder Director Arnone has put forth.
And social media, of course, is so crucial in this day and age.
Social media is good. And the other thing, too, that this website has really done, because as part of our reach out, we have many different, we have our stakeholders internally, and we also have our citizens. So it's a place that they can go to and really get good information.
Right.
It's a great place. They can find out about the Freeholder Board, what we're doing.
And what about the energy plan?
On the energy side, this has been really exciting, because one of the areas where we really think that we can make some real impacts is around energy. The cost of energy has continued to go up. So what we did was we formed an energy committee. And as part of the energy committee, again, we went out and we got our stakeholders involved, whether it's engineering or other departments, to take a look at what are some of the ways that we can help to reduce costs. So we currently, we just got a grant to go out and have a company come in and take a look at the operations, all of the energy costs that we have internally. That'll be phased in. This is the second phase of that. And then when we're done with that, we expect to be able to put that into a 1, a 5, and a 10-year plan that we expect that we'll be able to roll out across the county. Again, gathering data so that we know where we can save money in a very efficient way.
And Freeholder, there's a storm preparedness part to the energy plan?
Yes. This has kind of come about. It's kind of an interesting way that this came about. I don't think any of us were prepared for Sandy.
Right.
And one of the really scary parts of it, when we lost power, one of the areas was around traffic safety. I remember on Route 34, they put buses across the intersections just to protect people so that they didn't try to go across the across the roads. I happened to be with a company along with our engineering department, and there was an idea thrown out about solar-powered traffic lights. So we've been working on solar-powered traffic lights now probably for about 6 months. We have our control units at each of the intersections, and that's been kind of our challenge, is how do we make sure that the batteries are charged, not from a primary standpoint, but as a backup.
Right.
I think most people don't realize that all you have to do is knock down a telephone pole, traffic lights are out, we have to get the police to come. So we're looking at this as a way of kind of being a backup. I know that several legislators have spoken to me about it. They're very interested. I know the Bayshore is very interested in that as well. I've also worked with Rob Clifton to try to help us try to see if we can get this also pushed out into potential legislation. Mm-hmm.
And the strategic plan is always somewhat of a plan in working, right? I mean, as times change, I would imagine that that's going to change as well.
It is. One of the other areas that we're looking at is tri-generation. If you look at Monmouth County with our new 911 building can really be the center of communications in any kind of a major storm or any major occurrence because of what we've done here. Our 911 center is state of the art. And one of the ideas that I had was what I would call hardening of the of our infrastructure using trigeneration. Trigeneration is nothing new. It's not anything exotic. What it does is we use natural gas to power a standardized engine, and that will help us to create electricity should the electric grid go down similarly that it did in the past. Mm-hmm. So we're looking at that we're looking at trigeneration for the 911 building as well as for the jail. So we want to have a hardened infrastructure and also for IT. If you look at Kozlowski Road, that whole campus, we essentially would build a utility on that site so that it's hardened, so that if anything should happen outside, we would really be in a great position to make sure that we maintain our communication infrastructure.
All right, Freeholder, lots of great information out there. Thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you, Cynthia.
And for more information, you can always go to www.visitmonmouth.com. I'm Cynthia Scott. Have a great day, everyone.